Hey, Chief Meteorologist Kendra Kent, Fox Carolina Weather Center. Dorian is front and center when it comes to our weather coverage the next several days. Of course, we're not on the coast. We're in the Western Carolinas, and our weather will be essentially unaltered. We're going to have a little extra cloud cover. May have a little bit of a breezy day on Thursday especially, but we're not going to get a whole lot of impacts out of Dorian. But I know many of you have connections to the coast, and it could be a very different story along the North and South Carolina coasts. Randy, I think that the storm is likely going to pass very close to Wilmington on Thursday, late Thursday, potentially Friday, but probably on Thursday. But everywhere from Charleston to Myrtle Beach to Wilmington up toward the Outer Banks, any of those spots could see a landfall. We're happy to see that most of the computer models still keep it offshore, but that doesn't mean the impacts won't be great. We're looking still at very strong wind, probably a Cat 2 as it goes by the Carolina coast, which is, again, not a Cat 5, which is nice, but it's still going to be rough. Let me show you the latest. Here's Dorian as a Category 5 storm now. 185-mile-per-hour winds. And if I take off the marker there, you can see how intense it is. I say see how intense. Look at that eye. I mean, it just doesn't get any fiercer. You've got this perfectly symmetrical, just completely calm center. The eye of the storm, as we always call it. And right around the outside, that's where we're getting those 185 mile per hour sustained winds. And that's moving into an area called Sweeting Cay and is basically moving right for Freeport in the Bahamas. And that's a pretty populated area. So scary stuff. And we're going to be hearing reports out of the Bahamas, see what the damage is like. We've seen some video out of the areas already hit, and it's pretty bad. So this is pretty catastrophic situation for those in the Bahamas. This will take years to recover from, kind of like it did for areas like Puerto Rico when Maria went by. It's just going to be bad. But the good part of the story for the Carolinas is that it will be weakening as it moves north. And the question is, when is it going to make that turn? And how strong is it going to be around this time? Notice that at 2 p.m. on Monday, still expected to be a Cat 5, but weakening to a Cat 4 by 2 p.m. Tuesday. Now, Tuesday, that's when we need to see it making a really good little northern turn, Tuesday morning especially. If we aren't seeing that, that's what's going to really tell us that it's probably going to come a lot closer to the coast than we expect. The next step would take it as a Category 3 Wednesday at 2 p.m. right near Jacksonville. A disturbance is going to pick this thing up, not really pick it up, but help to steer it, because this is much bigger and more powerful than the actual disturbance. But it's going to cause a weakness in the high pressure and allow the storm to move north. But then it's going to eventually get picked up in the upper level flow and move off northeast. So Category 2 off the coast of South Carolina on Thursday at 2 p.m. That's what it looks like right now. But again, a lot of variability possible here. And really, I mean, at this point, you could probably shrink the cone down to about like this, because I haven't seen a thing that takes it out this far, and I haven't seen a thing that takes it out that far, but certainly right there. Some of them have it basically right on the coast, and some have it a little farther offshore. And then there it is moving out to sea as a Category 1 storm. That would be Friday at 2 p.m. Let's get a, I take the lock on this computer. It's going to glitch for a second, but then you'll get to see the graphics here. Okay, so it takes a second, but the storm's going to be about 40 miles off the coast if it takes that center track. Sorry about that. This is just this little refreshing phase the computer goes through when I switch computers. There we go. You can see I measured here, talking about 40 miles off the coast would be where the center of circulation would be located. That means that we could at least get Category 1 force wind gusts in this area, most likely sustained wind between 40 and 60 miles per hour if it did take this track. Here's a look at our computer models. And they are in decent agreement, but not great. Of the storm staying offshore. You still have a couple that try to take the storm right up along the coast, and then some that take it very, very close, like the European and the GFS. They don't make a landfall per se in South Carolina, but it cruises so close that we'd feel some pretty big impact. But then you go over a little farther to the east, and we've got this nice clump of models, and this is what we're hoping for right here. And that's pretty good. The majority of the models keeps it far enough off the coast where the major impacts would be offshore. We'd still feel some of it along the Carolina coast. So this is, again, what we're rooting for happening. But as you all know, things have changed with this track. So it could easily change again. We have a few days until this is going to impact the Carolina coastline. Here's a look at tropical storm force winds. A very good chance that we'll get those along the Carolina beaches. 70% chance where you're seeing the orange color. And then you move up toward the upstate, very low chance that we're going to get 40 mile per hour winds. So that's at least comforting. For those of us in the Western Carolinas, this isn't going to affect us a whole lot. But here is a look at the GFS that keeps the center of circulation offshore until we get to North Carolina, but then it tries to make a landfall somewhere along the North Carolina coastline, close to Myrtle Beach. See what I mean? It kind of takes a pretty quick northerly jog there and kind of heads right into North Carolina, but stays off the coast of South Carolina for the most part, still brings very heavy rainfall. That's Thursday at noon, and then late Thursday it would be starting to move out. Here's the European model, and this one hasn't updated in a while. We'll get a new one late tonight. But notice that it takes it just off the coast. It's a pretty strong storm. And then makes a landfall somewhere along the Outer Banks. Kim, you're right. Very uncertain. Alyssa, I'm not sure. Depends on what kind of, how much damage there is. The evacuation stuff is very tricky, but all signs point to the danger being done by Friday. So as long as there's not a lot of, if there's not catastrophic damage or anything like that, if you've got a trip planned to the beach next weekend, you should be able to get down there. But again, there'll be it'll be difficult. There'll be a lot of people traveling back down after having evacuated. All of a difference to bet lives on. So I completely understand why there was a mandatory evacuation. Even though most models do keep the storm off the coast, it could easily end up on the coastline. Now, for those of you watching, kind of interested in Florida, really the threat for Florida has gone down and down, even though there are hurricane warnings for Florida because of the fact, even though it'll be offshore, you're talking about a Category 4 hurricane going by just about 50 miles offshore. So it makes sense. There's going to be some very strong wind for spots like Fort Pierce up toward Melbourne, Daytona Beach. It's going to be really, really close. And then this is going to be so crucial to see how this thing curves out to sea. So we'll know a whole lot more here as we go forward in the next 24 hours. And I know we've been saying that, but we are getting at least a better picture every single time. And then leading up to it, we ought to have a really good idea by late tomorrow what Wednesday and Thursday are going to hold. So we will have much more information coming up on the 10 o'clock news. Tom is asking about Alabama. Alabama not even close to an area that's going to be impacted, so you're going to be fine. You're welcome. Thank you so much, you guys, for being here, for checking in, because it's important. We want to make sure everybody knows what's going on. And if you're here in the upstate and worried about this, at this point, there's no reason to be worried yet. If anything changes, we will let you know. But of course, our friends along the coast could be dealing with quite adverse conditions as this all works through. So we'll keep you posted, and we'll have much more on those lane reversals, the evacuation order, coming up on the 10 o'clock news.